when I smell a rose, I know the rose by the scent. So where's the scent in the brain?
This is the world's first microprocessor, and I sat down with its inventor to talk about consciousness.
We basically are projecting to the computer what is our property, but is not a property of the computer.
Does it understand what it's doing in the sense that we do?
He says, I'm depressed much of the time.
I'm sorry to hear that you're depressed.
It's not a number. What I feel goes beyond numbers. You see, we go into a domain of existence that goes way beyond what physics has ever studied. And the problem here is that physicists have never worried about consciousness because that's the problem of neuroscientists. Neuroscientists don't know quantum physics, so what the hell? Consciousness is a quantum field. The body is a structure in space and time that is quantum and classical because the cells are made of particles and atoms and molecules that interact quantumly, but they interact quantumly in space and time.
I think Federico managed to, for the first time, give us a satisfying account of this dichotomy, the classical world and the quantum world.
This reality that we call reality, the reality in space-time, is classical. So the body is a bridge between consciousness and this classical world. All I have said so far is what quantum physics is saying. One is the universe, and the universe is dynamic and holistic. So this is just what we already know.
Yeah.
But I add one thing. One wants to know itself. One wants to know itself. So we are fields created by one to know itself.